Make up your snips at this coded locus. You work so well inside a streptococcus. I'm so alone without your scissors in my chromosome. Cut me up and do it clean. CRISPR Cas9, bring me a gene.
Maybe it's just the tinnitus kicking up in me, Okay, well, that's one way to teach science. That was a new music parody from Tim Blaze, a master's degree holder in high energy thermonuclear physics from McGill University. Alex corrects me. Theoretical physics from McGill University, who explains scientific topics on his YouTube channel, A Capella Science. That was one on the revolutionary CRISPR technology, which has played a big role in battling the coronavirus. Let's bring in right now professor of history at Tulane University, Walter Isaacson. His latest biography is on one of the scientists who discovered CRISPR. It's titled The Codebreaker, Jennifer Doudna, Gene Editing and the Future of the Human Race. So, Walter, break this down for me and for the audience. I'm a liberal arts guy. I had to take biology in college. It's the only reason I had to get 4 credit hours. I got it. I mean, that was before core curriculum. So as Denzel Washington said in the movie Philadelphia, explain it to me like I'm a fifth grader, because in this area, I am like a fifth grader.
This is a wonderful technology developed over the past few years by Jennifer Doudna, the hero of my book, Emmanuel Charpentier, her research partner, and many others, that allows us to go in and edit our genes. And it's just a simple scissors that's connected to a guide. The guide is a snippet of RNA, that same wonderful molecule that's helping get us all vaccinated. But that molecule acts as a guide and said, okay, that gene for sickle cell anemia or cystic fibrosis or whatever, cut it out. And eventually you could say, okay, and replace it, change the genes in our system. So not only can we fix perhaps genetic diseases, but the long range thing is perhaps editing our children to have certain traits that we want. So this is a huge boon to the health and, you know, the human race, but it's also going to present us some challenges to figure out, hey, when do we use it to edit our kids?
And do you talk about that as far as the ethical challenges? I mean, I know there are a lot of parents out there that say, wait, we can edit our kids?
It kind of sounds good to me.
It's just a joke for parents. But now, obviously, there's some real ethical problems, real ethical challenges here. How do you address that in the book?
Well, Jennifer Doudna, who helped invent this technology, and she just won the Nobel Prize for it. One day, she had a nightmare soon after she invented this gene editing technology and the tools to use it. And she walks into a room and somebody says, I want to learn about this technology. And the person looks up and it's Hitler. So she decides that she's going to gather scientists and policymakers from around the world to say, all right, what are we going to do with it? Now, just this past year, we used it. Victoria Gray, a wonderful woman down in Mississippi, got cured of sickle cell anemia by editing the gene. But the year before in China, a rogue doctor used it to edit early stage embryos. It turned out to be twin girls, so that the edits were inheritable. In other words, it would go down through all the human race. Now, at first, everybody's shocked. On the other hand, the edit he made them less susceptible to getting a virus. Now, if you could do that safely, we have to ask ourselves, all right, down the road, do we want to edit our species to be less susceptible to viruses? So there's no easy answer, but in the book, I walk hand in hand, you know, step by step, because slopes are less slippery that way when you go hand in hand, step by step.
Hey, thanks so much for watching our YouTube channel. You can follow up on today's top stories and breaking news or catch up on your favorite MSNBC shows all in one place. Download the NBC News app today.